Hi, I'm Anna Crichlow and I'm playing Ruby. So Ruby's quite down to earth. She runs the cafe in this seaside town. She's kind of very sweet and sometimes seems a bit simple even. But we kind of, as the play develops, we see that she kind of has this inner strength and that she's a really hard worker, proper grafter, and that kind of pays off in the end, maybe. Overall, probably a lot of laughter. A lot of, I didn't expect that. It's kind of quite zany as a play, and there are big characters, and it's just an amazing 90s vibe. So yeah, a lot of fun.
Can you talk about how much fun it was working with the rest of the cast?
Oh, it was such a delight. Like, they're all such lovely people, really down to earth, chill to work with. And it was a really open space, especially working with the director, Rob. He was just so great, allowing us to play with stuff and play with each other. So it was really enjoyable, yeah, from start to finish. Working with Tanya, again, it was so lovely. Like, we get on really, really well. We both love to sunbathe so much. So every lunchtime, we'd go to the park and sun ourselves. And, like, being the only girls in the cast has had really nice girly chats. And, yeah, it's been so fun. And she's so great and worked so hard. So, yeah, it's really admirable for her. Yeah.
Is it quite hard to keep a straight face during some of the more hilarious moments in it?
I think you just get used to it. And also, like, you know, most of the time you're just in the moment of your character being in that pickle or being in that kind of annoyance. So, you know, obviously you hear the laughter and you feel the laughter, but you're in a completely different space in your head. So it's kind of easy to ignore it when you're thinking of it like that. Yeah. So obviously it is quite classic 90s, but there's a kind of boldness to everything that everyone's wearing, especially the young people, which I think is really nicely contrasted when you have the character of Mr. Bayliss, who's a bit more muted. So you kind of get the older generation, younger generation coexisting. And then with the set, you know, they've kind of gone really realistic in Ruby's Cafe, but then the rest of it is this kind of almost like psychedelic, kind of roller disco-y kind of vibe. So you get those neons, you get those bright lights, you get that kind of rave feeling that was very much a thing, especially in seaside towns in the 90s. So it's got realism, but it reflects the energy that was going on at the time. So I think it's a really clever set. Amelia is an incredible designer, so yeah. I think having local theatre venues, I mean, I'm from South East London myself, so obviously having these theatres that are in South London, it makes it so much more accessible for people. You know, they can literally go just a few minutes down the road and they can actually go and see some amazing theatre. And Boundless are just great. They care so much about young people and what they care about and what influences their lives. So I think they're always bringing plays like this to their, you know, to see for these young people. So they feel like their voice is being heard and they can get a few things reflected back to them, you know? So, yeah.